If you look at the American population, 64 to 75 years old, 25% have some degree of hearing loss, which they report as a disability. But by the time you get to be more than 75 years old, 50% of people have some degree of hearing loss. So in our laboratory, we study cellular physiology, cellular structure, the interconnections between nerve cells and sensory cells in the cochlea. And we examine that three-dimensional structure with microscopy and virtual reality. The ear talks to the brain through neurons that carry information from the ear to the brain. But then there are also neurons in the brain that project back to the ear and regulate the sensitivity of the ear. Driven by sound, these efferent neurons from the brain, they regulate the sensitivity of the cochlea to protect the ear from acoustic trauma, from very loud sound. So our studies on animal models of this efferent feedback pathway have shown us that there's a particular molecular change that we can make which provides greater protection against acoustic trauma. And we're now generating an experiment where we can design a kind of gene therapy strategy, a way of increasing that negative feedback loop from the brain and thereby providing better protection to the ear. So the really great thing about the David M. Rubenstein Professorship and Endowed Research Fund is that it stabilizes the research effort for an individual, but it also provides resources that can help to facilitate or accelerate novel kinds of experiments that reach out not only within our immediate group of investigators in our own department, but more broadly across the university. There's an incredible thrill in seeing something for the first time. But now we're at the cusp of applying some of that knowledge to think about real world problems and how that information can be applied potentially as a therapy.